Mark Bronson. Nothing breaks like a heart. BBC Radio Stoke. Now it's the biggest day in the horse racing calendar. Unless you've been under a rock, you're over thousands in their clubs. Descending on Angel for the Grand National this afternoon.
Head with a tremendous chance of winning his third national. He jumps in third of Turtle Down Point. He's getting the most tremendous cheer from the crowd. They're winning it home now. The trophy of all red run, being preceded only by loose horses, being chased by Church Down Boy. Uncatchable's moved into third for Bill Garlic fifth.
You know what's interesting about that is that little Ruby who's put together the show today, she's only a young one, and we were talking about that horse, and she went, that horse, Red Bull. I went, that horse, Red Bull. Now David Carr's from the Racing Post and he's here to talk to us this morning. That horse, Red Rum, do you remember that horse, Red Rum, David?
Oh, God, Jeff, I have to say, hats off to the producer of all the expectations. That was absolutely tremendous. Third actually, the horse is so good for their national. That is where they're going to get 80 million on top of the race. He closed down for the first breath and now this is the key. He won the horse of the race quite nicely in the country. When he won the race,
valuable jumps race line virtually anywhere in the world. So there are a lot of good horses running here, particularly now the fence has been changed, so it's not quite so dangerous as it used to back in Redcastle today. So they're all good quality. It could well be that Calvin's in a third, fourth round fence, about 28 will be spreading contention, so you should get a good round for your money.
Well, this is the thing, you were saying about Red Rum in the 1970s and that. We used to watch it when you just had your one telly, and you know, as kids, we'd all have our own horses, and you'd either pick it because the horse was grey or the jockey was wearing purple silks or something, and then you'd sit, like you say, and you'd think, oh, get on with the first 3-4 miles because I just want to see the finish line now.
Last year, 4.5 miles, we saw the Titanic finish to neck and neck at the finish and a 50-1 winner, which again just shows, outsiders do win as well.
Now, Dave, you work for the Racing Post, so, you know, this is not your first rodeo, as they say. Do you have a flutter?
I haven't on this year's race. I did it yet. Well, you knew it was the last minute, the test of ground. But for those aficionados amongst your listenership, that has dried out for the night. It was from soft down just because a lot of rain was dried out. As always, on that national day, it's going to be a lovely sunny day. The ground's going to dry. It's going to be just on the soft side of the good night this afternoon. I'm really keen on Colin Campbell, horse trainer Scotland Bundy, Sydney Russell. She won it 6 years ago with one for Arthur. And it looks just the right for a horse to go really well. for you. This month last year, I came to Berlay, well, it's the Butosca, your own course. He's run over the Grand National Tennis Court and run really well. The worry about him is he'd be suited by it was 3 1/4 rather than 4 2 miles.
Right. So they're not just going to shorten it just for him, are they? You see, so I did breakfast yesterday on the show, and between 6 o'clock yesterday morning and you now, I've only got 50p, babe. I've now got about 7 horses that people have told me to buy. He's already there getting set up for the day, quite literally.
Gets farther from LA. Maybe it's supposed to be.